Hey guys and welcome back. So today I'm going to be discussing my favourite top 10 anime series. Now I'm not saying these are the best anime series or that you should definitely go and watch them, but for me they're my favourite and it's either because of nostalgia purposes or because I really like some of the characters or the storyline or because it just intrigues me. I don't know why. There are a lot of series on this list that are very, very similar, so please forgive me if it's not completely varied, they're just my favourite animes. So let's just get straight into this. Dragon Ball Z is definitely up there as one of my top 10 favourite anime series of all time, and I think that's mostly due to nostalgia. I'm not saying it's the perfect anime, and I'm not saying it's my favourite anime, and just for you guys to know, I'm not putting this list in any particular order because it took me long enough to pick my top 10 anime out of all the series that I've seen, let alone put them in order. But for me, Dragon Ball Z definitely has that nostalgia factor. I used to run home from school every single day as a child and tune into Dragon Ball Z religiously. I absolutely loved it. It was one of the very few animes that I had available as a child and I just fell in love with it. So the best part about Dragon Ball Z for me is that it has so many different characters, and I know for a lot of different anime series this can be a really bad thing, but I think that it works because it spans over Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z and Dragon Ball Super. We won't talk about GT, but because it spans over so many different series, I think having so many characters and so many background stories and so much development in the characters, it completely works for this series. And I don't really want to give any spoilers, but for this series, I do want to say that it is about fighting a lot of different aliens and a lot of different people and a lot of different threats. So that's what this anime is basically about, and do you know what? I live for it, I love it. Let's move on to the next one. Log Horizon is like a very mature Sword Art Online, and for those of you who don't know what Sword Art Online is, it's about a guy who goes into a video game, gets trapped in the world. There's a lot of animes on this list that are very similar to Sword Art Online, so I apologize for referencing Sword Art Online. But for those who have watched it, because it's a very well-known anime, it's easier to reference that when comparing it to Log Horizon. So Log Horizon has a very similar basis as Sword Art Online, however it just feels more grown up. I really enjoy the storyline and it does have a few more twists and turns than Sword Art Online. I'm not really going to get into it very much, but the main character might not be very likable at the beginning, but he definitely gets more likable as it goes on, and I don't know, I prefer it because it just feels a little bit more realistic, even though it's an anime and it centers around things that are generally improbable. So next on the list, and yes, I'm definitely a weeb, so I'm gonna mention Death Note, and I know that people are like, oh, it's overrated, but actually it's got a really, really good storyline, and there's definitely twists that you just don't see happening. It's about a guy who finds a Death Note, and people's names he puts in the book generally end up dead, and it follows a detective and the person writing the names in the book, and it's very, very intriguing. It's not like a lot of action actually happens, but it's very good and I highly recommend Death Note, even though it is a very popular series and lots of people have watched it. It's a reason why it's popular. It's because it's good. So let's move on to the next one. So another really, really popular anime that's on my list is My Hero Academia, and I did not think that I would enjoy this series, but I absolutely love it, and the reason why I love it is because the characters are very, very easy to relate to. They all have their own personal struggles. You find out a lot about the characters, not at the beginning, but as it goes through and you learn about the characters and you develop with the characters as they're learning about each other. And it's just really good the way that they've done it. And even if you're not into the basics of the story where there's superpowers involved, it's still a really good anime to watch. So I'm gonna leave her at that and move on to the next. Rising of the Shield Hero is yet another anime along the same lines of Sword Art Online, where a character gets transported to another world and can't get out. But I love this mainly because at the very, very beginning there's a massive twist, and it just makes you really, really relate to that character, and you get to feel all his emotions, exactly how he's feeling them, because you can definitely put yourself in his boots. And I can't like explain why I love this series so much, and with each season it seems to be keeping just as good as the very first season. I can't wait for the next few seasons to come out, and I'm hoping it doesn't decline in quality, but at the moment it is definitely one of my top 10 anime series, and I can't explain why unless you watch it, because I don't want to spoil the story for you, so let's just move on. Another really nostalgic anime for me is Outlaw Star, and I absolutely love this series. And every time I think Outlaw Star, the opening tune gets stuck in my head every single time without fail. But that being said, the storyline is actually pretty good, and it's generally got a serious tone all throughout, but it definitely has some more comedic moments. And I would definitely recommend watching it if you do like space adventure sort of anime series, and if you don't, then it might be worth just listening to the music, because I give it a absolute 10 out of 10. I absolutely love the intro to Outlaw Star. I don't know why, it just brings back really happy memories for me. Okay, I'm really sorry about this one. It is another very popular anime, but it is very, very cringy to a lot of people. But I love it. It's Naruto Shippuden. And I'm saying Naruto Shippuden because I was a massive fan of Naruto growing up, but Shippuden just takes it to another level. It's so much better than Naruto. The first episode in Naruto is really good, but Shippuden just takes the biscuit. It's so, so much better. You see so much more character development through the characters. The fight scenes are absolutely amazing, and if you followed Naruto, you know how far he's come in his journey, and I just can't get enough of Naruto Shippuden. However, that being said, if you've watched Naruto and Naruto Shippuden, I do not recommend watching Boruto, which is Naruto's child. It's not a very good series as far as I've seen, and I've not seen that many episodes, so I could be completely wrong, but what I've seen, it's just not as good as Naruto or Naruto Shippuden. However, Naruto Shippuden definitely has a lot of different characters, very, very different personalities, and I very much like a lot of the background characters, not particularly the main characters. So the next anime I was very, very wrong about. I thought because of the name of the anime that I just would not like it. I thought that it was going to be about guys trying to pick up some hot girls, but it's not. It's completely different. It's Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon? Now, hearing that title alone just thinks, oh, it's going to be really bad. It's going to be comedy. But actually, it's not. It's about an adventurer who is trying to make his way in the world. And again, it's not anything like the title makes it out to be. It's a very, very good anime series. And because of this, I think I enjoyed it more because I was taken back. I was like, wait, this isn't what I signed up for. But yeah, I would definitely say at the moment it is one of my top 10 anime series. So another anime series that I really, really like that's kind of similar to Sword Art Online, but again, nothing similar to Sword Art Online, is Overlord. And what I mean by that is, yep, it's about a guy who gets stuck in a video game, but it's from a completely different perspective. Now, he already knows he's very, very overpowered, and most of these genres start off with the main character being very underpowered and then building their way up and becoming like a legendary status, but he's already started his journey as a legendary status. But what makes it so different is the perspective. Like I said, you have both his perspective and then the villagers, the NPCs' perspectives. And saying that, I don't want to give any spoilers away, but it makes for a very interesting story, and for that reason it is up there in my top 10. There are so many animes that I would love to put in this list, but I can only have 10. So my last anime in this list is Grimgar of Fantasy and Ash. And again, it's a very similar anime to Sword Art Online, but again, not at all. It's one of those animes that I'm like, oh, I wish I had friends like that. It's about a group of adventurers, and you see it from all of their points of view, and you feel for each character. They feel really relatable, same as Log Horizons. I think the Log Horizons and Grimgar of Fantasy and Ash are roughly on the same level. They have a very similar feel to them, even though they're completely different, where I think Log Horizon has more of a, oh, okay, this one character is taking charge, but Grimgar Fantasy and Ash is like more, these characters have come together and it feels more bonded. And I don't know, I know people can disagree with that, but I just really, really like anime series where you get immersed in an online game, and I don't know why, I've just fallen for that sort of trope. I just really enjoy anime series with that. And I have mentioned a lot of Sword Art Online in this list, and people are probably expecting to see Sword Art Online. It is very good, but it's not quite there. I still think Grimgar, Fantasy and Ash, Log Horizons, Overlord, How Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in the Dungeon, that sort of genre, I feel like those are slightly better than Sword Art Online. Please don't hate me. I know it's a good series, but I just feel more related to these other characters than Kirito. But anyway, that is it for my list. I did not want to go into any spoilers, because if you want to watch the series, feel free to watch any of the series that I have listed as my top 10. Although I would say that you might not enjoy Naruto, Death Note, or any of the older, cringier animes, because a lot of people's attitudes towards anime has changed now, and when I was growing up we were very limited, so a lot of these are nostalgic or very trapped in a video game-esque type of anime series. So that is it from me. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye guys!